Amen.
Congratulations, Kalai sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Govardhan. Thank you, Kalai.
Please enter with your name.
Kadir, welcome.
Please enter with your name. 22DEF79B. உங்களோட நேம் என்னன்னு சொல்லுங்க, நாம மாத்துக்கணும் கூட மாத்தி கொடுத்துறோம். அல்லது சாட் பாக்ஸ்ல உங்க நேம் டைப் பண்ணுங்க, நான் மாத்திறேன். 22DEF79B. On A6D68BE7. Please tell your name so that we can change.
Babu. Welcome, Dr. Komala.
கலை, உனக்கு தான் பேக்ரவுண்ட்ல வாய்ஸ் கேக்குதுன்னு நினைக்கிறேன். மத்த எல்லாரும் வீட்ல இருக்காங்க. பேக்ரவுண்ட் குழந்தைங்க வாய்ஸ் கேக்குது. இப்ப கேக்குது தம்பி, பேக்ரவுண்ட்ல கேட்டேன். பேக்ரவுண்ட்ல குழந்தைங்க வாய்ஸ் தான் கேட்டுச்சு, அது உன்னோடதான் கேட்டேன்.
மணி சார்
வந்துட்டாரு. வெல்கம் மணி
சார். குட் மார்னிங் சார்.
குட் மார்னிங். குட் மார்னிங். குட் மார்னிங். நான் லிங்க் அனுப்பல, நான் லேட்டா தான் அனுப்பினேன். சேவ் நம்பர் தான்
இல்லங்க? யூனிவர்சிட்டில நெட் வந்துட்டு போகுது, அதனால தான் சார்.
ஓகே ஓகே, நோ இஷ்யூஸ் நோ இஷ்யூஸ். ஓகே சார், வந்துட்டாங்க மணிகள சார், வந்துட்டாங்க.
ஓ சரிங்க சார். சார் குட் மார்னிங் சார்.
வெல்கம் அலி சபி சார்.
இந்த 22DEF மட்டும் யாரும் சொல்லுங்க, நான் பேர் மாத்திறேன்.
22DEF79B.
வீடியோ ஆன் பண்ணிருக்காங்க, பட் பேர் தெரியல.
W2DEF79B. நீங்க உங்க நேம் டைப் பண்ணிட்டீங்கன்னா அவங்க நேம் ஆட் பண்ணிடுவாங்க. நம்ம
அதே மாதிரி கீழ SW5T ன்னு ஒரு பெரிய நேம் இருக்குது யாருன்னு தெரியல.
SW5TA
வீடியோ ஆன் பண்ணிருக்காங்க பட் யாருன்னு தெரியல.
மீரா, மீரா ஜி, மீரா அவங்க நம்ம பிசிக்கல் டைரக்டர் சண்முகா காலேஜ் திருவண்ணாமலை, நம்ம ஓல்டு ஸ்டூடெண்ட். SW5TA ப்ளீஸ் டைப் யுவர் நேம், தே வில் ஆட் யுவர் நேம். SW5TAG90 in the chat box you can type your name, they will add your name. Okay Mani, Mani Lalu sir,
open sir.
Okay candidate. Manoj ji.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, we are starting the program.
Okay.
Yes, Dr. Mani.
Yeah, very good morning, wonderful gathering here. It's my immense pleasure to welcome the gathering of BIOC examination of Mr. R. Kalaiselvan, full-time PhD student, under the guidance of Dr. Rajiv Kumar sir. So, in this fine occasion, first of all, I would like to welcome our external examiner, Dr. Manoj, assistant professor from Allahabad. So, on behalf of the Department of Education, we wholeheartedly welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
I do welcome the research supervisor and convener of this BIOC examination, Dr. Rajiv Kumar, sir, assistant professor, Department of Physiology and Physiology Biomechanics. So, on behalf of the Department of Education, we wholeheartedly welcome you, sir. I do welcome Dr. Kalaiselvan. He is a very good karate player, very good teacher. So in this presentation, I welcome PhD scholar. I do welcome our department faculty members, Dr. S. Tirumala Kumar sir, professor. I do welcome all the faculty members from Department of Education. I do welcome all the faculty members from Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University. And also I do welcome all the professional colleagues from the various affiliated colleges and physical education professionals. So on behalf of the Department of Education, I wholeheartedly welcome. I do welcome all the MPhil and PhD scholars and also my dear lovable students. I welcome one and all in this fine occasion. So now I hand over the session to Dr. Rajiv Kumar sir to introduce the examiner and the scholar. Please, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Manikandan, for your valuable welcome address. Before I introduce the external examiner as well as the scholar of this YYOC examination, I would like to give you some regulations. The candidates who are entering, please enter with your name and please mute your mic during the presentation, during the discussion by the external examiner. If at all, if you want to convey anything during the question hour, you can raise your hand, right? And you can type in the chat box. So the organizers, Dr. Manoj, will let you in where you will be given time to raise your questions. So during the presentation and during the discussion, please mute your mic so that we can process and conduct this YYOC examination in an efficient way. So with this, I would like to introduce Dr. D. Manialagu, the external examiner of today public YYOC examination of Mr. R. Kalaiselvan, who is under my guidance. And Dr. D. Manialagu is a well-known personality in the field of physical education, and he has guided 34 PhD scholars so far and 60 MPhil scholars so far. And he has a wide experience, more than 2 decades, almost spanning of 22 years in the capacity of assistant professor in the Department of Physical Education, Alagappa University. And he is a very good researcher who applies the theory into practice. And his project, some of his projects is the testimony which says that he is a very good researcher. And he has got research grants from University Grants Commission as well as ICSSR. From University Grants Commission, he received 25 lakhs to carry out research projects, as well as he received 15 lakhs from ICSSR, and he successfully completed the research projects. And at present, he has 5.25 lakhs research project from the agency, funding agency, ICSSR, that is Indian Council for Social Science Research. And he is like Rajaraja Chola. He not only served within the country, also he got the name and fame across, that is out of India, because he visited Singapore, Netherlands, South Korea. Also, he is having a collaborative project with Thailand, India governments. Apart from this, he has got so many awards, national as well as international levels. And he received Korean Research Fellow Award in the year 2020. Recently, he received. So my heartiest congratulations on behalf of the participants, sir. And also, he received an outstanding research award from National Sports University, South Korea, in the year 2018. And some of the national awards which are to be mentioned are Dr. Robson Award for Physical Education and Excellence in the year 2019. And he received an Excellence Award for research from his home institution, that is Alagappa University, as well as he also received UGC Research Award. And not only that, he is a very good social worker, and he gives a lot of free training, coaching to the in and around downtrodden population of Alagappa, Karaikudi and Sivanga districts. And he has been awarded a social service award by a lot of Lions clubs. And apart from this, he has presented more than 130 papers in the international and national level conferences and journals. And he is a very good human, always has the zeal to learn. And we have such a nice personality as an external examiner for today's YOC examination. So on behalf of the university and my personal behalf, I welcome you, Dr. D. Maniyalagu, sir, for this YOC examination in the capacity of external examiner. Sir, welcome you. And now, I am going to introduce the hero of today YOC examination, that is none other than Mr. R. Kalaiselvan, who is the research scholar of today's YOC examination, who is going to defend his findings on analysis of dominant factors that determines goalkeeping performance among field hockey goalkeepers. He is goalkeeper himself by profession. He started his career in YMCA Sports School as a goalkeeper, and he received the first rank in the technical course offered by YMCA Sports School, that is physical education. And after completing his schooling, he joined the pioneer institution in India, that is Madras Christian College, and he received his BSc physical education in the year 2009, and he stood as a second ranked student in that course. After completing his undergraduation, he moved to pursue his higher education in the one more pioneer institution in India in the field of physical education, that is YMCA College of Physical Education, where he completed his Bachelor of Physical Education, that is BPED, MPED and MPhil in the years 2010, 12 and 13 respectively. In the year 2014, he approached me for the PhD regular program, where I wholeheartedly accepted because hockey is my specialization. Moreover, he also belonged to my same position goalkeeping or goalkeeper. So I was also a goalkeeper during my school days and college days. And apart from this, his sports achievements, sir, during his school days, he represented Schools Games Federation of India National Games, representing Tamil Nadu in the year 2005. And he also a winning team participant of Bharatiya Day Sports in the year 2006, representing YMCA Sports School. And apart from that, during his college days, he represented Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University in the inter-university competitions in the year 2010, 11 and 12. And also he represented Tamil Nadu state team in the senior nationals. And apart from this, he also served as technical official for the All India Inter-University Tournaments, which was held in Tamil Nadu Sports University for the South Zone as well as for the All India. And having the background of hockey, after coming to me, he was very much interested to learn biomechanics, and he learned Dotfish, R software, Kinovia and Longomatch, which were all video analysis softwares. And he has the zeal and enthusiasm to learn the components in biomechanics. He wanted to specialize in biomechanics. So his enthusiasm and perseverance made him to get a job in Madhya Pradesh Sports Board. He is presently working as a video analyst in Madhya Pradesh Sports Board, Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal. So with this, I would like to give a small introduction about this topic. The moment he came to me, both being the goalkeepers, both guide us as well as a scholar, we had a lot of things in common. And as a professional hockey players in the capacity of, in the position of goalkeepers, we have been with the hands of so many coaches. After our professional career, also we handle so many teams and so many big questions come in front of us. Some of the coaches prefer goalkeepers who are agile, who are having better reaction time, who are having better physical prowess, neglecting the anthropometric parameters like height and other stuff. And some of the coaches are very particular about, we are least bothered about the physical prowess, because we will develop the physical prowess, we need tall people to be the goalkeepers. And India, if you see the Indian goalkeepers, there are so many tall guys like AB Subbaiya and Ashish Balal. And also we have seen Bharat Chhatri and some of the goalkeepers who are of normal height and stature, but all achieved. And we had a big question whether anthropometry decides the goalkeeping performance or the physical fitness parameters or the biomechanical parameters or the psychological parameters, because some goalkeepers perform better during the practice matches, and when it comes match, tournament, tough matches, they fail. And even our team players, when we go for some tough tournaments, they used to say, he is very good at right side and he is very weak on left side. So these are all the so many comments come from the a research study, what are the major determinants? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So with this, I hand over the session to Dr. D. Maniyalagu, the external examiner.
Manoj sir.
Manoj sir, now you can continue.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your nice introduction about me and the scholar and the title. Before going to my official proceedings of this YYOC examinations, I extend my sincere gratitude and hearty thanks, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Sheila Stephen Madam, most respected Registrar, Professor Gopinath Sir, most respected the Controller of Examinations, Professor Ramakrishnan Sir, for nominating as an excellent examiner of this YYOC examinations. And also my special thanks to the research supervisor, respected Dr. Rajini Kumar Sir, for including my name in his evaluation panel. And also my sincere thanks to the professor and head Department of Physical Education, Dr. Manikandan Sir, for welcoming the gathering. My hearty welcome to each and every one of present here. The research topic chosen for an analysis of dominant factors in goalkeeping ability among field hockey goalkeepers. Now I invite the research scholar, Mr. Kalaichelvan, to present your research work in this learned forum. I earnestly request to all the viewers, if you want to clarify any doubts within the presentation title, you may ask after the scholar presentation. Now, over to the research scholar, Mr. Kalaichelvan, please.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Good morning to one and all present here. Myself, R. Kalaichelvan, full-time research scholar in the Department of Physical Education. Under the guidance of Dr. P. Rajini Kumar, I welcome you all for my PhD YYOC examination. My research topic is analysis of dominant factor in goalkeeping ability among field hockey goalkeepers. Introduction. Everyone knows field hockey is one of the most popular game in India. India won 8 gold, 1 silver and 2 bronze medals in the Olympic Games until 1980. India is the cradle of world hockey. In field hockey, goalkeepers is the pillar of the team. A goalkeeper alone can fetch the victory to his team. All top teams in the world highly rely on goalkeeper's contribution. In case of tie-break situation, the goalkeeper performance can change the match results. Most of the matches won by the goalkeepers, perfect saves and fabulous performance that everyone knows who they are and how they are contributed in Indian field hockey as a goalkeeper. From 1956, Shankar Lakshman, Charles, A.B. Subbaiya, Ashish Balal, stop yours. There is no air refreshener on earth that can cover up the smell of my equipment. You can hit on me, but you cannot score. Through this code, I justify the reason of my present problem. Nowadays, goalkeeping coaches are appointed separately to train the goalkeepers. In the past decade, a coach used to look after the whole team. But in the modern hockey era, a separate coach is appointed to the goalkeeper and the game has experienced a paradigm shift to position-specific training. We could see in India, executive goalkeeping workshop being conducted at various places. It is a long time question that how to select a goalkeeper and what are the key parameters to be considered in selecting a goalkeeper. The coaches vary in their opinion and the choice whether to select a goalkeeper who is tall with better reaction time, speed and agility with good reflexes, self-confidence, leg power with good velocity. The coaches differ in their opinion. Research studies conducted on field hockey is a very few and studies on hockey goalkeeping is scarce. Hence, being a goalkeeper, the investigator represented a Tamil Nadu and played lots of matches for university level tournaments. The investigator was enthusiastic and committed to conduct a research on finding dominant factors influencing hockey goalkeeping ability. For my study, I reviewed lots of literature. From this literature, I shown here how in the year wise. Total 56 reviews are collected. In field hockey, I collected only 16 regarding related to my topic. Statement of the problem. The purpose of the study was to analyze the dominant factor influencing the goalkeeping ability with regards to biomechanical, anthropometric, physical fitness, psychological variables among the field hockey goalkeeping. Objective of the study. To find out the relationship between the hockey goalkeeping ability and biomechanical variables, namely force, velocity, asymmetry, peripheral vision, reaction time, ambidexterity, and kinesthetic sense. To find out the relationship between the hockey goalkeeping ability and physical fitness variables, namely speed, agility, dynamic balance, flexibility, and muscular power. To find out the relationship between the hockey goalkeeping ability and anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, height and weight. To find out the relationship between the hockey goalkeeping ability and the psychological variables, namely self-confidence, sports performance anxiety, and personality. To predict the dominant factor influencing the hockey goalkeeping ability. Significance of the study. The study was significant in the following ways. The outcome of the study would help coaches to design that suitable training program to improve the performance of hockey goalkeepers. To find out the study helpful to identify the strength and weakness of hockey goalkeepers. The results of the present study would help to find out the innovative training methods to improve goalkeepers' performance. The findings of the study would help to understand the techniques of goalkeepers in match situation. The outcome of the research study would help to helpful to the coaches to select the suitable goalkeepers. The results of the present study would help the coaches to predict the goalkeeper's performance with a scientific and systematic procedure. Hypothesis. We have framed 5 hypotheses for this research. The first hypothesis of the study that there would be a significant relationship between goalkeeping ability and selected biomechanical variable, namely force, velocity, asymmetry, reaction time, peripheral vision, ambidexterity, and kinesthetic sense. According to the second hypothesis, that there would be a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and physical fitness variables, namely speed, agility, dynamic balance, flexibility, and muscular power. The third hypothesis states that there would be a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and selected anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, height, and weight. According to the fourth hypothesis, that there would be a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and selected psychological variables, namely sports performance anxiety, personality, and self-confidence. Finally, the fifth hypothesis states that the dominant factor, namely biomechanical, physical fitness, anthropometric, and psychological variable, would predict the goalkeeping ability among hockey goalkeepers. The study was delimited to the following aspects. The study was delimited to 30 goalkeepers who represented in the university tournament from Tamil Nadu state for the last 5 years. The age group of the subject was ranged from 18 to 28 years. The study was delimited to the following variables: dependent variables as goalkeeping ability and the independent variables such as biomechanical variables, namely force, velocity, asymmetry, peripheral vision, reaction time, hand dexterity, distance perception jump test, kinesthetic obstacle test, pedestrian kinesthetic test, and the physical fitness variables, namely speed, agility, dynamic balance, flexibility, and muscular power. The anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, height, and weight. The psychological variables, namely self-confidence, sports performance anxiety, and personality. Limitation. The study was limited in the following aspects: the subject's living condition, lifestyle, diet, personal habit, family heredity, emotional status, motivational factor were not taken into consideration. the subject social, economic, and cultural background were not taken into consideration. The subject's routine work was not controlled, and its possible influence on this result of the study was not noted limitation. The previous fitness level of the subject was not considered. Methodology. For this study, 30 main hockey goalkeepers were selected. The independent variables, namely biomechanical, physical fitness, anthropometrical, and psychological variable, and the dependent variable as goalkeeping ability. For my study, I have choose this kind of equipment. The MyJump app is a scientifically developed to measure the height, flight time, velocity, force, and power of vertical jump, and it also measures the contact time, vertical stiffness, and reactive strength index of drop jumps, along with the force velocity profile and asymmetry test, as reliable as standard force platform. The sports vision trainer was used to measure the visual reaction of the subject. The vision training for sport is the application to specific exercise while performing visual perceptual tasks, leading to enhanced visual motor performance. Vision disc. The vision disc was used to measure the field of vision of the and determine the range of peripheral vision of the goalkeepers. Hand tool dexterity. Ambidexterity is the state of being equally adapted in the use of both left and right hand at the same time. The hand dexterity is the ability to use your hands in a skillful, coordinate way to grasp and manipulate object and demonstrate small, precise movements. Reason for selection of variables. The field hockey goalkeeper need a much mental, physical, technical, and tactical preparation as the field player. According to Barth and Nordman, 2005, goalkeeper have a extremely composed and mentally strong because it can be super unwearing when the opposing team is attacking. Goalkeeper is also the last line of defense, which makes it all the more pressuring. Goalkeeper must always be alert, react quickly, and he especially should not be afraid of the balls. Goalkeeper must also have excellent reflexes and good hand-eye coordination in order to stop those quick shots by the opposing team. Goalkeeper must be able to block or save all types of shots which can travel at speed in excess of 90 miles per hour. According to Ander and Myers in 1998, goalkeeper must have good concentration and the ability to quickly spot the angle on the shot. Courage, confidence, quick reflexes, mental toughness, excellent vision, excellent high end hand and foot coordination, gymnastic ability, strength and agility, the ability to read the game, and willingness for leadership are the all properties needed by the goalkeeper. According to Durden and Hare, 2000, the maintenance of strength, flexibility, and stamina will promote good body balance and footwork, which enable the goalkeeper to perform reliable goalkeeping technique and quick reflexes. The success of a goalkeeper is to have good basic skills and basic saves to improve importance include instep save, getting wide clearance, hand save, left and right, and many more. For the goalkeeper, the speed and strength are vital components for the better performance. Reflex saves, a very good goalkeeper, are vital to the performance. According to Cardman, 1985, all good goalkeepers must maintain and a high degree of flexibility, strength, stamina, and concentration. All above, they must have confidence. It is an essential characteristic that all goalkeepers must possess, along with good judgment, fast reactions, and good techniques, always are agile. Leg strength is an essential physical fitness component, which helps the goalkeeper to kick the ball for distance and do faster movements. Speed of reaction is the greatest importance of goalkeeper. Attentiveness, self-confidence, and being well-rested are all factors that shorten reaction time. Based on these many parameters, I selected this variable for my research study. selection of subject, the minimum age of the subject was 18 and the maximum age of the subject was 20 and the mean value of 21.56 and the standard deviation 2.95. The height minimum 164 and maximum 180 centimeter and the mean value 172.03 and the standard deviation 5.05. And the weight minimum 61 and maximum 83 and the mean value 69.18 and the standard deviation 5.05. Sampling design. The study was formatted as simple random sample group design. 30 field hockey goalkeepers were selected for this study and the age of the subject ranged from 18 to 28 years. The selected subject plays university tournaments from Tamil Nadu state for the last 5 years. Criteria for measuring the selection of subject variables. Goalkeeping ability was tested through the subject rating by 3 experts with the mark 100 marks. Force, velocity, asymmetry was tested through the MyJump app 2 and the peripheral was tested through vision disc in degrees. The reaction time was tested through sports vision trainer. The ambidexterity was tested through the Bennett hand tool dexterity in seconds. For the kinesthetic sense, the distance perception jump test, kinesthetic obstacle test, and pedestrian kinesthetic test was used. Anthropometric variables. Leg length and arm length was tested through stilt tape, and the height was tested through stadiometer, and weight was tested through weighing scale. The physical fitness variables, such as speed, tested through 30 meter, agility was tested through hexagon test, the dynamic balance was tested through bus dynamic balance test, and the flexibility was tested through sit and reach test, and the muscular power was tested through standing broad jump. For psychological variables, the self-confidence was tested through Valley's self-confidence questionnaire, and the sports performance anxiety was tested through sports performance anxiety scale, and the personality was tested through Eysenck personality inventory revised. For my study, I used MyJump app 2 for my research work. Through this app, I measured the force and velocity. Let's see few clippings which illustrate how to measure the force and velocity. This image was taken during my data collection. As I mentioned before, the same app, that is MyJump app 2, here I used this app to measure the asymmetry. Let's see the video how to measure the asymmetry in this app. This image was taken during my data collection. Peripheral vision. Goalkeeper with good peripheral vision can cover the angle of the goal and save the goal as well. So for this study, I measured peripheral vision through this vision disc. This image was taken during my data collection. For a goalkeeper, the reaction time is more important at the reflection of ball and rebound situation. So for my study, I measured reaction time through this sports vision trainer board. Here, see the how to performing. Ambidexterity. As I already mentioned, ambidexterity is the use of left and both hands. For my study, I used this hand tool dexterity. Goalkeeping ability is in field hockey is the ability to safeguard the goal efficiently. The goalkeeping ability is determined by the following criteria such as position, angle covering and recovery, quickness, speed and agility, anticipation, judgment and decision making, interception, tackling and clearance. For my study, this picture was taken during my data collection. The goalkeeping ability was assessed by judgment rating and shootout test performance for the total of 100 marks. 10 shootout trials were given to each goalkeeper and trials were performed by different forwards with adequate intervals. Three judges who were qualified hockey coaches acted as a judge to assess the performance of goalkeepers during shootout test. The average of score of the three judges' scores was considered as a final score of the subject. In my research work, I have used the statistical package of social science, that is SPSS version 20.0 for Windows 7 and the descriptive stats, person's product moment correlation, partial correlation and multiple regression was to analyze the data at 0.05 level of confidence. Descriptive stats was used to find out the mean and standard deviation of selected variables. From this table shows that the minimum and maximum value of goalkeeping ability was 78 and 90 marks respectively. The mean and standard deviation were 83.96 and 3.398 marks respectively. The Pearson problem correlation coefficient was used to determine the significant relationship between the selected variables and goalkeeping ability. From this table, the goalkeeping ability had strong positive correlation with force, velocity, peripheral vision, and kinesthetic obstacle ability. And the goalkeeping ability had strong negative correlation with asymmetry, reaction time, and hand dexterity and distance perception ability, and had a weak negative correlation with pedestrian kinesthetic ability. From this table, the goalkeeping ability had strong negative correlation with speed, agility, and had moderate negative correlation with dynamic balance. And had the goalkeeping ability had a strong positive correlation with flexibility and muscular power. The table shows anthropometric variables and goalkeeping ability had strong positive correlation with height and had moderate positive correlation with leg length and arm length, and had a weak positive correlation with weight. According to psychological variables, the table shows the goalkeeping ability had positive correlation with self-confidence and had moderate positive correlation with personality extroversion and had moderate negative correlation with sport performance anxiety and had a weak negative correlation with personality neuroticism. The scatter plot showing the relationship between goalkeeping ability and biomechanical variables. The force, velocity, peripheral vision had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, and asymmetry, reaction time, hand dexterity, distance perception ability, and pedestrian had a negative correlation with goalkeeping ability. Here the scatter plot shows the relation between goalkeeping and physical fitness variables. The speed, agility, dynamic balance had a negative correlation, and flexibility and muscular power had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability. The scatter plot showing the relation of goalkeeping and anthropometric variables, namely leg length, height, arm length, and weight, had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability. The scatter plot showing here goalkeeping ability and psychological variables, namely self-confidence, had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, and personality extroversion had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, and the sports performance anxiety and personality neuroticism had a negative correlation with goalkeeping ability. Partial correlation was used to find out the relationship of each independent variables on goalkeeping ability after eliminating the influence of other independent variables. To find out the accurate relation between goalkeeping ability and velocity, the influence of other independent variable was partialed out, and the results of partial correlation showed that the velocity was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability about 78.6%. The peripheral vision was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability about 85.7%. The reaction time was positively negatively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 71%. Hence, the correlation of velocity, peripheral vision, and reaction time on goalkeeping ability in linear correlation and positive correlation was almost identical, and the influence of other independent variables. To find the accurate relationship between goalkeeping ability and distance perception ability, the influence of other independent variable was parceled out, and the results of the partial correlation shows that the distance perception ability was negatively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 73.5%. The speed was negatively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 89.88%, and the agility was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability only by 76.8%, and the muscular power was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 70.2%. The leg length was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 79.7%. Height was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 75.2%. The sports performance anxiety was positively correlated with goalkeeping ability by 74.3%. The leg length, height, and sports performance anxiety on goalkeeping ability in linear correlation was influenced by other independent variables. Multiple regression. The multiple regression statistical technique was used to predict the influence of selected independent variables on goalkeeping ability. The above table reveals that the selected independent variable were very much influencing the values of hockey goalkeeping ability. From R square value, it is clear that 99.7% of hockey goalkeeping ability was determined by the selected independent variables. It was found that the multiple correlation coefficient R 0.998, which indicate that there was a predictor of high level of multiple correlation with goalkeeping ability and nearly a good predictor of dependent variable. Also, the table indicates that the multiple regression coefficient obtained between the criterion variable of goalkeeping ability with the selected predictor variables, which was 0.997. ANOVA. The ANOVA tables whether the overall regression model is a good fit for the data. The table shows the independent variable statistically significantly predict the dependent variable. The F value 151.250 at significant 0.05 level. The results of ANOVA table reveals that the regression model is a good fit of the data. Regression. The regression model predicts that the increase in 1 unit of velocity will increase the hockey goalkeeping ability by 56%. The 1 unit of decrease in velocity will decrease the goalkeeping ability by 56%. The increase in 1 unit of peripheral vision, that means 0.087, will increase the goalkeeping ability by 8.7%. The 1 unit of decrease in peripheral vision will decrease the goalkeeping ability by 8.7%. The increase in 1 unit of reaction time, 0.018, will increase the hockey goalkeeping ability by 1.8%. The 1 unit of decrease in reaction time will decrease the goalkeeping ability by 1.8%. The decrease in 1 unit of distance perception ability, 0.408, will decrease the hockey goalkeeping ability by 40.8%. The 1 unit of increase in distance perception ability will increase the goalkeeping ability by 40.8%. The decrease in 1 unit of speed, that means 10.45, will decrease the hockey goalkeeping ability by 40.45%. The 1 unit of increase in speed will increase the goalkeeping ability by 10.45%. the increase of in one unit of agility 1.652 will increase the hockey goalkeeping ability by 1.65%. The one unit of decrease in agility will decrease the goalkeeping ability by 1.65%. The one unit of flexibility 0.188 will increase the hockey goalkeeping ability by 18.8%. The one unit of
decrease. Show the graph, Bob. Show the graph. Sorry, sir. Show the graph.
Here the graph shows unstandard coefficient values. The one meter per second of velocity will increase the goalkeeping ability by 56%. The peripheral vision increase in 1 degree, the goalkeeper ability will increase in 8.7%. The 1 second of reaction time will increase the goalkeeping ability by 1.8%. And the distance perception ability, the 1 point will decrease, the goalkeeping ability will decrease in 40.8%. The 1 second of speed will decrease, the goalkeeping ability will decrease in 104.5%. And the 1 second unit of agility will increase, the goalkeeping ability 1.65% will increase. 1 centimeter of flexibility will increase, the goalkeeping ability will increase 18.8%. And the muscular power will decrease in 1 meter, the goalkeeping ability will decrease 540.7%. And the leg length will decrease in 1 centimeter, the goalkeeper ability will decrease in 7.3%. And 1 centimeter of height will increase, and 14.3% of goalkeeping ability will increase. And 1 point of sports performance anxiety will increase, the goalkeeping ability will increase by 3.3%. Regression equation. In this prediction equation was formulated out of experiment done in this research, velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, distance perception ability, speed, agility, flexibility, muscular power, leg length, height, and sports performance anxiety are the highly predictors of the goalkeeping ability. Here, the scatter plot showing the linear relations of selected independent and dependent variables. The trend line slope showing the positive linear relationship on regression. The point above the trend line indicates the positive relationship between the hockey goalkeeping ability and the other independent variables. And the points below the trend line indicates the negative relationship between goalkeeping ability and the other independent variables. The model of good fit of the data at 99.7% of association with goalkeeping ability. Discussion on findings. Biomechanical variables. The results of linear correlation reveals that the association between hockey goalkeeping ability and force is directly proportional to each other. Similarly, the association between velocity and hockey goalkeeping ability is also directly proportional. Further, the results reinforce our findings that force and velocity is directly proportional to each other. Hence, the force and velocity have strong association with goalkeeping ability. The relationship between asymmetry and hockey goalkeeping ability is inversely proportional. The findings further state that the association of peripheral vision is directly proportional to goalkeeping ability. The peripheral vision helps the goalkeeper to have a better view of the ball and player on the field with wide angle. Hence, goalkeeper with better peripheral vision would have better goalkeeping ability. The reaction time had an inverse relationship with hockey goalkeeping ability. The goalkeepers with less reaction time can react to any situation on the field. The reaction ability helps the goalkeeper to react to the speedy balls quickly. The kinesthetic obstacle ability was directly proportional, and the distance perception ability was inversely proportional to goalkeeping ability. there was no association between pedestrian kinesthetic ability and goalkeeping ability. The findings of posture correlation reveals that velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, and distance perception ability were associated with hockey goalkeeping ability after eliminating the influence of other independent variables. Hence, velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, and distance perception ability are directly associated with hockey goalkeeping ability, and goalkeepers with better ability in the same compound would perform better. Similarly, the above said variables such as velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, and distance perception ability found to be the predictors and dominant factors, that is biomechanical variables, influencing the hockey goalkeeping ability. Findings on physical fitness variables. Speed, agility, and dynamic balance were inversely associated with hockey goalkeeping ability. The goalkeeper with better speed can approach the oncoming ball quickly and interrupt and tackle the ball from the opponents. Hence, it is obvious that the better goalkeeper would have a minimal time in speed and agility. The dynamic balance is an ability which helps the goalkeeper to move quickly to the ball and slow down and balance his body as he approaches near the ball. Speed is inversely proportional to force, velocity, and peripheral vision, which reinforce the findings of the study. Further, the findings reiterate that goalkeeper with better ability in force and velocity would have better speed. Agility helps the goalkeeper to move his body in different direction quickly and approach the ball. The agility is inversely proportional to force, velocity, and dynamic balance. Agility is directly proportional to reaction time, speed, asymmetry, and distance perception ability. An agile goalkeeper can easily and efficiently tackle the ball from an opponent while he is dodging. The association of muscular power and flexibility is directly proportional to hockey goalkeeping ability. A goalkeeper with good muscular power can move faster and kick the ball at greater velocity. A goalkeeper with better flexibility can approach and start for the ball to save the goal. The association of muscular power and flexibility with force, velocity, and peripheral vision is directly proportional. Further, the association of muscular power and flexibility with speed, reaction time, agility, and dynamic balance is inversely proportional. The findings of posture correlation reveals that speed, agility, and muscular power are directly associated with hockey goalkeeping ability, and they are not influenced by any other independent variable. Hence, the coaches may identify goalkeeper with good speed, agility, and muscular power. The results of prediction reveals that speed, agility, flexibility, and muscular power are the predictors and dominant factors influencing hockey goalkeeping ability. Discussion on anthropometric variables. The findings of linear correlation reveals that leg length, arm length, and height variables are directly proportional to hockey goalkeeping ability. The stats are helped a goalkeeper to cover the goal area easily, and arm length and leg length helps him to reach for the easily and quickly. Further, height is directly proportional to arm length and leg length. Hence, it is essential that the goalkeeper should be tall to reach for the ball and cover the angle of the goal. Height is directly proportional to force, velocity, peripheral vision, kinesthetic obstacle ability, flexibility, and muscular power. The association of height with asymmetry, reaction time, hand dexterity, distance perception, ability, speed, and dynamic balance are inversely proportional. The results of posture correlation showed that height and leg length variable are directly associated with hockey goalkeeping ability, and this variable are least affected by other independent variables. Further, the findings of prediction also reinforce the findings of posture correlation that height and leg length are the predictors of goalkeeping ability. Findings on psychological variables. The results of linear correlation between psychological variables and hockey goalkeeping ability reveals that the self-confidence and the personality extroversion had positive correlation with the hockey goalkeeping ability and performance, sports performance anxiety has an inverse relationship with goalkeeping ability. The goalkeeper should be confident enough to stay on the goal. Goalkeeper is the last line defense, and they are like an undesignated coach inside the field. Goalkeepers communicates and coordinate with his defender to foil the opponent's attack. They watches the whole game being inside the field as one among player of the team. The pressure on the goalkeeper is always more, and the goalkeeper must have the ability to maintain his anxiety level to perform better. The sports performance anxiety is inversely proportional to muscle power, flexibility, peripheral vision, force, velocity, leg length, arm length, and height. The sports performance anxiety is directly proportional to asymmetry, hand dexterity, distance personal ability, speed, and self-confidence. The results of positive correlation reveals that sports performance anxiety had a significant relationship with goalkeeping ability. The results of prediction further reinforce that sports performance anxiety is a predictor of hockey goalkeeping ability. Discussion on hypothesis. The first research hypothesis states that there will be a significant relation between hockey biomechanical variable and hockey goalkeeping ability, such as force, velocity, asymmetry, peripheral vision, reaction time, hand dexterity, kinesthetic obstacle ability, distance perception ability, and pedestrian kinesthetic ability. From the research that there will be a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and biomechanical variables, namely force, velocity, asymmetry, peripheral vision, reaction time, hand dexterity, kinesthetic obstacle ability, and distance perception ability. From the research that there was no significant relationship between goalkeeping ability and pedestrian kinesthetic ability. Hence, the research hypothesis was partially accepted at 0.05 level of confidence. According to the second research hypothesis, there was a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and physical fitness variables, namely speed, agility, dynamic balance, flexibility, and muscular power. From the research that there was a significant relationship between physical fitness variables and goalkeeping ability, the speed, agility, dynamic balance, flexibility, and muscular power. Hence, the research hypothesis was accepted and null hypothesis was rejected at 0.05 level of confidence. The third research hypothesis stated that there was a relationship between goalkeeping ability and anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, height, and weight. From the research that there was a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, and height. And the research states that there was no significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and weight. Hence, the research hypothesis was partially accepted at 0.05 level of confidence. According to the fourth research hypothesis, states that there was a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and psychological variables, namely self-confidence, sports performance anxiety, personality extroversion, and personality neuroticism. From the research states that there was a significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping ability and psychological variables, namely self-confidence, sports performance anxiety, and personality extroversion. And the research that there was no significant relationship between hockey goalkeeping and personality neuroticism. Hence, the research hypothesis was partially accepted at 0.05 level of confidence. Finally, the fifth research hypothesis states that the dominant factors, namely biomechanical, physical fitness, anthropometric, and psychological variables, predict the goalkeeping ability. The results of the dominant factor, velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, distance perception ability, speed, agility, flexibility, muscular power, leg length, height and sports performance anxiety would predict the goalkeeping ability. Hence, the research hypothesis was partially accepted at 0.05 level of confidence. Following up the conclusion of the study, biomechanical variables, namely force, velocity, peripheral vision, and kinesic obstacle ability, had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, whereas the other independent other biomechanical variables, namely asymmetry, reaction time, and dexterity and distance perception ability, had a negative correlation with goalkeeping ability. Coming to the physical fitness variables, namely flexibility and muscular power, had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, whereas speed, agility, and dynamic balance had a negative correlation with goalkeeping ability. The third conclusion of the study, the anthropometric variables, namely leg length, arm length, and height, correlation with goalkeeping ability. According to the fourth conclusion, the psychological variables, namely self-confidence and personality extroversion, had a positive correlation with goalkeeping ability, and sports performance anxiety had a negative correlation with goalkeeping ability. From the findings of the study, it was concluded that if any goalkeeper has good at velocity, peripheral vision, reaction time, distance perception ability, speed, agility, flexibility, muscular power, leg length, height, and sports performance anxiety, they can be a good goalkeeper. So these are the predictors of hockey goalkeeping ability. Recommendation: the prediction model of the study, present study, may be adapted by the coaches in identifying the talents in hockey goalkeeper. The coaches, physical educational and trainers, should emphasize and improvise training methods based on the results of this study to improve the goalkeeping performance. Recommending to the SDAT, Hockey India, and FIS coaches may use this prediction to choose the field hockey goalkeeper from grassroots level. I recommended this coaches may use this prediction model to identify the strength and weakness of goalkeeper at elite level. Suggestion for further research: a similar study may be conducted by measuring the goalkeeping ability in real time match situation. The study may be conducted with larger number of samples, and also the study may be conducted for women field hockey goalkeepers. A study may be conducted with highly predicted variables for other major game goalkeeper. A similar study may be conducted to predict the performance of players such as defenders, midfielders, and forwards. And also, a video analysis study may be conducted to analyze the team's performance in a tournament. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kalaichelvan.
Thank you, sir.
Apt and a nice presentation about your entire study. Now, on to the next session of this VIVOS examination, the clarification of the doubts raised by the foreign examiner as well as the Indian examiner, followed by the viewers. The first one, Mr. Kalaichelvan.
Yes, sir.
Chosen more than 56 reviews. The reviews focused on the study conducted in the earlier periods. Why not you included the recent studies for your review purpose?
Yes, sir. Sir, I gone through literature. Lots of many more literatures regarding to hockey goalkeepers, but only very study are available. So I collected a review very sir, how do you put, sir?
The next one, whether the pilot study is necessary for your study?
Yes, sir. Because before going to the data collection, what are the difficulties we face while during the data collection? So before facing the data collection, to overcome the study, we go for pilot study is a better thing, sir.
Okay. The next one, one of the dependent variable, that is the goalkeeping ability, you assessed by the subject expert. So that is subject, when you observing the data through the subjective rating, we supposed to follow the ordinary scale or rank order correlation. But in your study, you won't use the rank order correlation. There is any special reason?
No, sir. Actually, for a judgment rating, we fixed and that's marks according to their performance. With consult with experts and coaches, we consult with them and fix the marks.
Thank you, Mr. Kalichelvam. Now, the audience may raise your clarifications within the presentations. If anyone can need to clarify your doubts, you may ask, please.
Two participants raised their hands. Yeah.
Sir, can I speak, sir? Rajini Kumar, sir?
Yes, sir. Yeah, carry on, sir.
Very good morning, all of you. First of all, I would congratulate the research supervisor.
Sir, not audible, sir.
Supervisor and the scholar. Actually, I have two in the...
Dr. Jayaraman, your voice is breaking. Please check your network.
Hello. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you are audible. Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, I have two suggestions. First suggestion is that in your recommendations, and you have recommended that the prediction of goalkeepers, really grassroots level, we could focus only on the fundamentals, not on the specific thing. So I think that could be in future. Thing is that for the reaction ability is much more important than the other qualities like speed and agility. So I think you could have used this for my.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable suggestion.
Like Dr. Jayaraman, still your voice is breaking. If you could come to the bandwidth.
Without a speed, without agility, without reaction, it is not possible to act as a goalkeeper. Am I right, sir? Jayaraman, sir?
No, sir. Actually, I stressed on the reaction ability.
Yeah, reaction is your point of view, I think you are saying that speed and agility is not much important. It is both are simultaneously it is required for this best goalkeeper.
So it's I just with the chat's permission I come into. So yeah, it is both are interrelated.
I want more explanation.
Any clarification?
Rajani, this is Vishu here. Rajani?
Yeah, Dr. Vishwanath, yes.
Welcome. Yeah, Rajani, yeah, thank you once again for your invitation. Rajani, am I audible?
Yeah, audible.
Rajani, two things I just wanted to cross on to Mr. Kalit Chelvan.
Yeah, sir.
He has undergone many variables. See, as a goalkeeper, my suggestion, if I hope you know, as a goalkeeper, anybody who prefers to be a goalkeeper should be out of fear first. Am I right?
Pardon?
Any goalkeeper who we are training to train should be out of fear. Fear is one of the major component.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I just wanted to know whether is there any way that he has come out to give a solution to come out of the goalkeeper fear level? Or is there any component like that? Any methodology that he has used to come out of the fear in a goalkeeper? Because that is one of the major aspects as a goalkeeper, I know. So, okay, this is one question which I wanted to ask. And the second thing is... Hello.
Yeah, you're audible, Dr.
Yeah, first question, is it understood, Rajani? The first one, what I asked?
Yeah, it is understood.
Okay, yeah. The second thing is that, why is that hockey stroke has been avoided? Why did they bring in the shooter? Is there any reason behind that to test the goalkeeper's thing, agility or whatever, something like that? Or it is purely the nature of the game which went on like that?
In this study or commonly you're asking?
No, I mean in general I'm asking. Is there any general implementation that they wanted to own? The first question is very much related to the goalkeeper, because unless you remove the fear out of a person who stands in that area, D area, D circle, it is very difficult.
Okay.
I just wanted...
It's a very good question, Dr. Vishwanath. I expect the scholar to answer.
So, I wanted to find out whether is there any way... Say that the scholar has found out the outcome.
Breaking, sir. Voice break.
Kalai.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Did you understand my first question?
Yes, sir. I understand, sir.
Fear is one of the major component in a goalkeeper.
Yes, sir.
I hope you're right. Okay.
Yes,
did you
sir,
find any way? Did you find any way to see that whether a goalkeeper has come out of fear? Is there any tool that you have used in a goalkeeper to see the fear level?
No, sir. For this study, I am not using any tools.
No, that is the major aspect of a goalkeeper.
Yeah. Okay.
I choose the elite level, sir. So
elite level will come from the grassroots level only. You cannot be elite level all of a sudden.
So I come to the rescue of the scholar, Dr. Vishwanath. Not only the goalkeeper. Sir, please others unmute. Sir, others mute. So you asked a question, very good question, that goalkeeper's fear must be measured. So I expected the scholar to answer for your question, but right now he is in fear, right? So and we measured self-confidence and anxious level of the sports performance, anxiety as well as self-confidence. So when anyone is having self-confidence, obviously it is interconnected. So when you are confident enough, then the fear psychosis gets rid of. So that's why we did not go for fear, measuring the fear directly, where we measured the other components like sports performance, competition anxiety, as well as self-confidence.
Rajani, you know why I put this question across?
Yeah.
See, self-confidence will develop with the players also. See, when you have 10 players around you, you will have your self-confidence. Okay. So, in order to measure the fear, that is the reason why I think, maybe I'm wrong, I think that is the reason why they bought in that shootout. To check.
The fear is nothing but the false expectations appearing real.
Yeah,
the false expectations appearing real is...
Clarification from the viewers. If you have, please ask to the research scholar.
Kalai?
Ma'am.
Yes, congratulations. Congratulations. The sports aspect all the psychological factors. It is adapted with the player. Fear, all the players, they will have a fear. Then you have chosen a self-confidence also. You have measured, I think so.
Yes,
then it is related to the player. And congratulations, you have taken 3-5 years experience you are having. So excellent job you did. On behalf of Department of Physical Education, let me congratulate the guide. Excellent guide you have got. If you are having more experience, then you can gain a lot. My question is, this is not a question, on clarification, okay? And which you have taken biomechanical variables, physical variables, psychological, very excellent variables you have chosen. Okay, both for guide and you, I'm asking, which biomechanical variable that is aspect as supported for your study to complete in successful manner? You have chosen the biomechanical variables, no? Which variable it is very suitable for you both to support that to complete the course, that is complete the research?
Okay. Ma'am, actually for my study, the biomechanical variable, the velocity and the peripheral vision is the main thing for a goalkeeper. The peripheral vision is the more important thing. Because while covering the angle, they should know whether the man is near to or there. And he also watch the ball at the side. Also, he have to watch who is near to me. So, for that reason, peripheral vision is influenced the more in the biomechanical variables.
Hello.
Ma'am. Yes, sir.
Hello. Yes, sir. Adini, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
You're audible.
Dear Kalai.
Yes, sir.
I have a clarification to be answered by you, right?
Yes, sir. Yes,
you have used the advanced reaction timer, which is available in our sports psychology laboratory.
Yes, sir.
Right. But when you are giving the proposal, that equipment was not available, but you have included that equipment for the better of your result. Kindly explain the advantage of that equipment for the audience.
Okay. So actually, why I use this equipment? Because
name of the equipment and explain the advantages, please.
Yeah, okay, sir. That equipment name is Sports Vision Trainer. It is from Australia. Actually, why I choose this reaction board? That means I gone through lots of research papers. Everyone done in that ruler drop test like that. So to initiate a new equipment, and I have got that facility to use that in our university. So only I use that equipment.
Okay, what are the advantages of that equipment?
It's easily it's a fully programmed one, sir. Yes. We have to fix it and fix the what type of reaction we need. What are the program we need? So for that, they will give automatic all the results within that.
Thank you, Kalai. Thank you. Congratulations to Rajini and
sir. Sir, this is Dr. K. Kannadasan. I would like to add 2 points to it with regard to the benefits of the sports vision trainer, which was used by Kalai, and just to simply to state. This particular equipment assesses your hand-eye coordination as well the reaction time of an individual, and the simultaneously if you feel that someone's reaction time or the hand-eye coordination to be improved very well, they can train with this equipment too. So it serves the dual purpose of assessing as well as training. So I hope I added some points to it. Thank you, sir. And I take this opportunity to congratulate both the scholar as well as the guide for the great effort and a great contribution to the entire hockey fraternity, where the biomechanical analysis area is coming up, and very well we could expect something to be happen for the entire nation, and these are all the studies, and these are all the studies which will give a very good idea even at the grassroots level. And one more point with regard to Vishwanathan sir, if I'm not wrong, he was asking about the fear of failure. I don't think so. It is not only the fear doesn't come only when a player approaches a goalkeeper to bang on the goalpost. Fear doesn't come there only. If you take when a participant want to compete in a sport, there also fear comes. When a player bothers about achieving, there also the fear comes. So without fear, if the player who has a fear cannot play any sport at all. And rightly pointed out by Rajini sir also, and there are it is directly measuring that particular variable is also well and good, but the other variables such as self-confidence was rightly measured, and one more psychological variables which was measured is really a factor which can be taken into consideration in this study. Thank you
Rajini.
Thank you sir.
Rajini.
Yes,
Rajini. Dr. Kannadasan has given me a good explanation. I'm happy with that. We should understand that the goalkeeper is the last defender. Okay. Yeah. That is where the chances of fear is more. See, when a forward lifts the ball, it is not that much. See, the wording says goes like this. The best way to defend is to forward.
Your point is well taken.
In that case, the goal... I'm telling you, fear... Yeah. Fear appears because being the last defender. See, that is where I just wanted to clarify myself.
It's understood.
Because if goalkeeper gets the ball, it is one way. See, if goalkeeper being the last defender, there ends everything.
Yeah.
It is at 100% the thing has been put on him only. See, that is where it rises. The fear rises only there. Everybody will have fear. That is common nature.
Yeah, okay. Dr. Vishwanath.
My understanding is that whether he has undergone any study for that particular fear aspect, I'm asking. That is what I just wanted.
Okay. Right. Thank you for your detailed clarification.
Thank you, Rajini. Thank you.
And sir, with the chair's permission, I would like to introduce or acknowledge the presence of the stalwarts in hockey. They are in the forum. That is none other than Dr. Saju Joseph, the High Performance Director, is here. And Mrs. Renuga Lakshmi Ma'am, who is the Honorary Secretary of Tamil Nadu Hockey Association. By respecting our invitation, she is here. And we have one more stalwart, the former Registrar of our Tamil Nadu Physical Education and Sports University, Dr. Sukumar Sir, who is a well-known hockey coach and lovable personality. And also we have Mr. Kannan, and we have a coach from Kerala. It is just a minute, sir.
Ali sir.
Ali, sir. Sabir Ali sir. Sorry, I had a gap. Sabir Ali sir is with us. And with this, I just welcome them all, and we can carry on with the clarification and questions. Yes, sir. Over to you, sir.
Rajini, sir.
Yes, sir.
Madras University Captain Celine Mary is there.
Okay.
Former Captain, Madras University. Oh.
Yeah. Dr. Celine Mary is here, and Dr. Jayaraman. And most of the hockey fraternity and lovers are here. And forum is open for questions and clarifications. And
Hello, sir. I'm Dr. Murugavaran. It's a very superb moment here. We have got a new research in biomechanics. So I really appreciate both the scholar as well as Rajini Kumar. So it was taken so much effort to make this study as a grand success. I congratulate the scholar for this presentation. And as far as there are many persons are talking about fear, but I don't know much knowledge about hockey. But I just want to put one word, because whenever a person likes to come as a hockey player, naturally he will be devoid of fear. Only after the dividing of fear he will take the job. So I don't think fear is fear is really, you have to know the exactly, but still you can take Vishwanath's position, and then next research you can add fear as one of the component, and we can really study on that. Okay, thank you one and all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Manilu, sir, over to you, sir. You can ask whether any questions from the floor, then we'll move on, sir.
Before my concluding remark, I request to you all, if you clarified any doubts within this presentation, you may ask to the scholar, please.
Good morning. So it was a very good session. I'm Mrs. Renuka Lakshmi, Secretary of Hockey Unit of Samantha. So
very
let me
morning,
wish
ma'am.
Mr. Kale Selvan. Mr. Kale Selvan,
very good morning, ma'am.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Rajini and all his team at the university. The session was really mind-blowing, very informative. But as secretary, I think this has to reach all the coaches at the grassroots level, especially the physical education teachers and the physical education PT teachers in schools and colleges. So I'm sure the association will really call on the UT for the promotion of this game, particularly very scientifically, as today where hockey stands. So thank you very much for this opportunity. I wish you all good luck. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for your presence. Thank you.
Dr. Rajini, sir, can I?
Of course, the goalkeeper, I would also like to say, excuse me, the
yes,
goalkeeping
ma'am.
Also a few as an experienced player myself, I would like to say, not as a goalkeeper, but I'm sure the confidence and the experience of the goalkeeper will make him psychologically strong to face any challenges that come towards him at the end of the game. So it all on his assertiveness, his strong attitude, and his experience, his confidence, everything together will definitely be able to challenge the last ball that goes into the goal. Of course, scientifically, I'm sure Mr. Kale Selvan will proceed with his research. But as a player, the previous said, I feel this is all together to make it a challenge. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so
to
much.
Overcome confidence. To overcome
Hello?
Hello?
Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is it audible to you?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. First of all, congratulations to you. This is Dr. Babu, hockey coach.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to have a small question to you. What prompted you to this status topic on goalkeeper?
Sorry, sir. I didn't get... Right, I asked you, sir. Actually, for field hockey play, there are lots of researches there. As I am a goalkeeper, there is if okay, it will be helpful to the coaches to for suitable training programs to improve the performance of hockey goalkeeper, and it's useful to help the coaches to select a suitable goalkeeper for a team from the grassroots levels.
Now, Dr. Saji Joseph sir is with us, and sir, please.
Yeah, Kalle Selvan, it's a good study.
Yes, sir.
Congrats. I just have one question to you. I just want to know whether the reaction time board, which was, it was it kept on a table or did you hang it on a wall?
No, sir. Actually, I kept it on the board only, sir. Why? Because for a goalkeeper, they have to move like this, that way. So, you have concentrated on the hand-eye coordination. So, that's why I am facing on the wall.
Wall. Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. That's because when I think in the video, it was shown as placed on a desk. So, yeah. I was wondering whether your study would be specific to a hockey goalkeeper or not. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Anyway, it's good that you done this study. One more thing is that, okay, probably something on upper extremity strength also plays an important role. Other than you have just tested the general strength, I think upper extremity, because you know the hand movement all depends upon the explosiveness of the upper extremity of the goalkeeper. So if you look into some goalkeepers like Ashish Ballal, who was the national goalkeeper,
yes,
if you see the lower body is quite heavy, but he is very quick on upper extremities. The hand movements are really explosive in nature. So that part, if it was also looked into, it would have added to the strength of the study. Anyway, congrats. It was very good.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for being with us. Yes, we have Dr. Sandil Kumar.
Yeah. I don't have any clarification regarding from your study. First of all, I would like to congratulate the scholar, Kalle Selvan, or he's presented his dissertation in excellent manner. Also, I congratulate this guide supporting the scholar for this wonderful research work. Mostly, this type of study is very rare. So, this is a wonderful study of this the field of hockey is required. That is, both these specialized person from this hockey presented a wonderful research work for their contribution. I congratulate both of the scholar and gay in this occasion. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Anyway, sir, you can conclude the session, sir.
Can I conclude?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you can move on.
Thank you very much, Mr. Kalle Selvan, for your...
Thank you, sir.
...and excellent interactions during the experts in the field of hockey. The chosen topic is an extraordinary one. Though I'm a football player, I am easily understood about the nature of the title. A success of any research program or any research, the first and foremost concentration may be focused on the chosen of a right research problem. If your research problem is in any ambiguity, your end results maybe goes wrong. Your research problem title is a simple, in an effective way. It has all the component. It is very easy to understand the layman. That is the success of any research. As far as this research is concerned, any good research have the four character. That is the nature of the study, which is independent component, which is a dependent component, and whom as a subject. this study clearly framed in these all four character. The first word itself, analysis, it shows the study analyzed various component. The study shows the nature, followed the independent variable, that is a dominant factors, then a dependent variable, goalkeeping ability, and whom as a subject of the study is clearly indicated, field hockey player. As far as the chosen study, it's clearly framed by the research scholar under the guidance of his supervisor. When you select a research problem in a systematic way, you identify the research gap that is more important. In this context, the research scholar stated in the chapter 2, summary of literature, he collected 56 reviews out of 56, 40 are other games, 16 reviews are related to field hockey. Out of 16, only few attempt made on this concept. Hence, he identified the research gap for the existing study to his present study. That is also very clear. In this methodology part, there is no doubt. All the testing protocol simplify with easily understanding with diagrammatic presentations. The chapter 4, it's a very, very essential part. In a research, as a researcher or as a research supervisor, we must concentrate more on the chapter 4, because adding the number of pages in the thesis, people are adding the chapter 1, chapter 2, more number of pages. I keenly observed the number of pages, especially this study is concerned 250 pages. Out of 250, 63% of the content focused presented in the chapter 4. I am very much happy, because many of the research findings are going the negative concept in this angle only. The chapter 4 very much presented with right results, with right statistical calculations. But my humble request here, the fourth chapter, the research scholar maybe include some of the earlier study findings, and you may link it with the earlier study findings and your findings. This is the one of the best theses as far as in the game of hockey goalkeeping is concerned. With the apt statistical arrived conclusions and findings, and the future suggestions is an excellent. So as a external examiner of this, particularly this YOS examination, I'm a football player, but I understand each and every aspect. There are 19 variables the scholar chosen for assessing the ability of the goalkeeping performance. In 19 variable, he explained, he tested in a systematic way, and his conclusions and his recommendations, it's very clear. And also the great biomechanics in India, as far as my knowledge is concerned, Dr. Saju Sojap sir here, and the secretary madam of Tamil Nadu State Hockey Union, Renuka Devi madam, is here. These two are blessings. Is very grateful to the research supervisor as well as the research scholar. In my concluding remark, after the scholar presentation, more than 13 questions are arised. All the questions are deliberated by the research scholar 99.9%. Only 1%, the research supervisor may involve to substantiate that value. I'm really happy to be here as an excellent examiner of the excellent topic. Based on the reports of the foreign examiners and the Indian examiners, based on the performance of this YOS examinations during the deliberations, I strongly recommend to the university authorities for awarding a degree Doctor of Philosophy in Physical Education to Mr. Kalaichelvan. After the university official formalities, they announced they awarded the degree of Doctor of Philosophy to Mr. Kalaichelvan. Year after, we are unofficially called Dr. Kalaichelvan instead of Mr. Kalaichelvan. Finally, I placed my heartiest thanks to the research supervisor, Dr. Rajini Kumar sir, who molded a normal soil into a golden solid god form or a solid structure of any shape. It's because of you only, sir. I congratulate to you for your wonderful and excellent effort to making this study became a wonderful one. In this juncture, once again, I record to my sincere thanks to the university for inviting me as an external examiner of this YOOC examinations. And my special thanks to all the viewers who patiently listening the scholar presentation, who actively involved in the during the deliberation section. Once again, I thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. On this occasion, with your permission, I also welcome Dr. E. Simpson Jesudas and Dr. Selva Lakshmi, who are the doctoral committee members of Mr. Kalaichelvan, so which I forgot to mention their name. And once again, my wholehearted welcome to Saju Joseph sir and Renuka Lakshmi ma'am and other coaches from across India. Now I hand over the session to the external examiner, which will be followed by proposal of vote of thanks by the scholar. Thank you, sir.
There is no further proceedings. May I request to the research scholar to propose your vote of thanks.
Sometimes the best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer among them. I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to everyone who supported me throughout the completion of my doctoral dissertation. I thank them for their inspiring guidance, invaluable constructive criticism and friendly advice during my research work. I sincerely express grateful thanks to my teacher, Dr. Sheila Stephen, ma'am, Vice Chancellor. I also very much grateful thank to Dr. V. Gopinath, sir, Registrar, Dr. Ramakrishnan, sir, Controller of Examination, TNPSU, for motivating me in all the aspects and giving me their valuable suggestion and continued support for my research work. I extend my sincere thanks to External Examiner Dr. D. Maniyadu sir, Assistant Professor, Alagpa University, for his valuable suggestions. He raised questions in friendly manner, which helped me to answer comfortably. Thank you, sir. I particularly grateful thanks to Doctoral Committee members for the assistance given by Dr. E. Simpson Desudas sir, Assistant Professor, YMCA College of Physical Education, and Dr. S. Selva Lakshmi ma'am, head of the department, and Assistant Professor, Department of Yoga, for their helpful support, scientific inputs, and advice in the successful completion of my research work. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. From bottom of my heart, I submit heartfelt thanks to my mentor, philosopher, well-wisher, and my beloved research guide, Dr. P. Rajinkumar, sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Exercise Physiology and Biomechanics, for his continuous support, patience, motivation, enthusiasm, and immense guidance with knowledge throughout the research work. His guidance helped me in all the time of research and writing of my thesis. I could not have imagined having a better advisor and mentor of my PhD study. He approached a brotherly manner for last 6 years,
motivating and inspiring every bit of me towards new possibilities in my life. He has been a living role model to me, taking up new challenges every day, tackling them with all his grit and determination, and always striving to come out victorious. Without his support, I could not have been able to complete much what I have done and become who I am today. It is impossible without you, sir. It's only because of you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. I personally thanks to Mr. Kartika Rajinikumar for her continuous support. She's always been there for me with all the tough situation which I have gone through in my research work as a sister. She's like my pillar of support. Thank you, Akka. I place a grateful thanks to Dr. S. Manikandan, Professor and Head, Department of Physical Education, and Dr. S. Thirumanikumar, sir, Professor and former Head of Head, for their infusing confidence and a sense of excitement and inspiring me about my work through their continuous encouragement. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I put special thanks should always to Dr. Shaheen Ahmed ma'am, Professor and Head, and Dr. K. Kannadasan sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Sports Management and Sports Psychology and Sociology, for always being kind, helpful, and motivating. Their assistant during the presentative work is grateful. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to express my sincere gratitude to Dr. P. Kumarvel sir, Dr. I. Lily Pushma ma'am, Dr. K. Rajesh Kumar sir, Dr. S. Jay Kumar sir, Dr. S. Velkumar sir, and Dr. C. Lakshman sir, Assistant Professor, Department of Physical Education. And my sincere thanks to Dr. P. K. Sendil Kumar sir, Assistant Professor, who had motivated me in all the aspects and also given their continuous support for my research work. Thank you, sir. I sincere thanks to Dr. Subramanian sir, Dr. R. Mohan sir, former controller, Dr. Grace Elena ma'am, head of the department, Dr. V. Mangakasi ma'am, Dr. Prem sir, Dr. Velkumar sir, sorry, Dr. Nallavan sir, and Dr. Vendesan sir, and faculties from all the departments for the guidance, constructive criticism, and wholehearted support and encouragement to me throughout the period of my study. I would like to express grateful thanks to Mr. C. Manoj sir and Mr. K. B. Srinivasan sir for their eternal support and understanding of my goals and aspiring in all aspects to complete this research work. Thank you, sir. My deepest gratitude to my hockey coach, Mr. Santosh, former hockey coach, YMCA Sports School, for his continued support and encouragement from day one I started hockey as a career in my life. Thank you, sir. I express my sincere thanks to Dr. Jackson Sudha Singh, sir, Dr. Jyoti Dayanandan, ma'am, Dr. Glory Darling, ma'am, Dr. David, sir, Dr. Johnson, sir, Dr. Merlin Tangadanil, sir, Dr. Jerome David, sir, Dr. Anbu sir, and Mr. Praveen Das, and all other staff who brought me from my post-graduation in YMCA College of Physical Education for their encouragement in all aspects to completion of my research work. I express my deepest gratitude to Dr. Jain Zagaria sir, head of the department, Dr. S.J. Prabhu, Mr. Nandana, Dr. Robin Amuldas sir, Mr. Michael Raj, Assistant Professor, Department of Physical Education, and Dr. J. Vishwanath sir, Physical Director, Madras Christian College, for their constant support and encouragement in all aspects of my undergraduate course to doctoral research work. I would like to record my sincere thanks to Dr. J. Anita ma'am, Assistant Professor in Strategic and Computer Application, for her valuable suggestion and constant support to calculate the data in a systematic manner. Thank you, ma'am. I extend my gratitude to Dr. N. Ashokumar sir, librarian, for his kind help to collect the reviews and source to complete the research work. Thank you, sir. I express my heartfelt thanks to all the PhD scholars and MPhil scholars of Tamil Nadu Physical and Sports University for their encouragement and support in exciting this research study. Thank you, my dear friends. I express my gratitude to all the non-teaching staff of Tamil Nadu Physical and Sports University for their kind help and support in my research work. My sincere thanks and heartfelt thanks to Dr. S. Viswanath, Senior Biomechanist, Malaysia, for all my personal, professional support and encouragement in all aspects to completion of my research work. Thank you so much. I sincere and heartfelt thanks to Mr. Anil Kumar and Mr. Anukumar Anna, Hockey India officials, and especially Hockey Unit of Tamil Nadu, Ms. Renuka Lakshmi ma'am, for all the personal, professional support and encouragement in all aspects to completion of my research work. My sincere word of thanks to Dr. S. Kalaimani, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, for her untiring support, personal and professional support and encouragement in all aspects of completion in executing this research work. I express my special thanks and encouragement to Dr. Ranjitana, Sadish Franklinna, Dr. Kartigeyan, Assistant Professor, Mr. Jagan, Mr. Subramanian, Mr. Mogandas, Dr. R. Purushottaman, Mr. M. Rajkumar, Mr. J. Parthivan, Mr. Gokulakrishnan, Mr. Meyergan, Mr. Praveen, Mr. Christie, and Mr. Miller for their help and support in my research work. My acknowledgement will never be complete without my special mention of my friend and my well-wisher, Dr. D. Sridharan and Dr. E. Vasanthakumar, guest lecturer, University of Madras, Dr. V. Ranjit, and Mr. M. Sendil Kumar, official director, and his family member, and my beloved brother, Raghu Varman, job from Sri Lanka, who has continually supported me during all this course. As always, it is impossible to mention everybody who had an impact to this work. However, there are those whose spiritual support is even more important. I feel deep sense of gratitude for my father, R. Ravichandran, and my mother, R. Kumuda, for their vision and taught me good things that really matter in my life. I don't imagine a life without their love and blessings. My brother, Mr. R. Kalaivanan, Vignesh Kumar, Sister Kalaivani, Tilakavadi, Bhanupriya, Abhinaya, and my auntie, Kodanaiji, for showing faith on me and giving liberty to choose what I deserve. I consider myself the luckiest in the world to have such a supportive family standing behind me with their love and support. Also, I thank all my relatives who helped me in several ways and motivated me to complete this research work. I wish to extend my gratitude to all those who have directly or indirectly supported me during this course of my research work. Last but not least, I express sincere thanks to all my subjects who have participated and involved in my research work. Thank you all. I owe all to God Almighty for granting me the wisdom, health and strength to undertake this research task and enabling me to this completion. Thank you all. If I miss anybody, please forgive me. I thank all the participants who have participated in my 5 hours examination. Thank you all. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Don't cry, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, everyone. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You're going to be a star.
Congrats, don't cry.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Congratulations, Kalai. And so thank you, the external. For everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Very nice.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
I think we can wind up, sir. Manila, sir.
Manila, sir, thank you so much, sir.
Dr. Mani? Dr. Mani, hello, sir.
Sir, Manila, sir.
Mute locker, ne?
Mute locker, yeah.
Kalai, ஒரு முக்கியமான நேம் மிஸ் பண்ண மாதிரி இருந்துச்சு கலை எனக்கு கேட்கல பேரு நீங்க அடிக்கடி போன்ல பேசிட்டு இருப்ப யாரும் எனக்கு தெரியல பட் பேரு மிஸ்
பண்ணிட்டேன்
சார் அன்மியூட் ஓகே சார்
சார் மணி சார் தேங்க்யூ சோ மச் சார்
கலை செல்வன் நீங்க பெரிய பிளெஸிங்ஸ் எல்லாம் நீங்க ரிசீவ் பண்ணிருக்கீங்க
கண்டிப்பா சார்
ஷார்ட்லி யூ ரிசீவ் குட் நியூஸ் யூ டோன்ட் வரி டாக்டர் மணி
சொல்லுங்களா ரஜினிகுமார் கம்ப்யூட்டர் இஸ் வெயிட்டிங் ஃபார் யூ சார் இன் யூனிவர்சிட்டி ப்ளீஸ் கம் பேக்
பார்டன் சார்
Cyril computer is waiting for you, sir. Please come back to university.
Okay,
sir. Okay. You didn't tell me
your name. Where are you from? Where are you from? Rajini Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 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 Guide.
Congratulations. Congratulations to Dr. Rajini Kumar and to Dr. Kalai. It's
thank
nice
you,
to see
you.
Thank
you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir.
Congratulations, Dr. Kalai and Rajini Kumar, sir.
Thank you, welcome, sir.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Sir, I thank everyone for being with us.
மேன்மேலும் அவருடைய அறிவோட சேர்த்து ஆற்றலையும் பெற்று டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்ல நீங்க ஒர்க் பண்ணணும்னு நான் இறைய வேண்டிக்கிறேன் நல்ல பண்பு நல்ல கைடுட உங்களுடைய பிஎஸ்சி முடிச்சிருக்கீங்க
ரஜினிகுமார் சார் கங்க்ராச்சுலேஷன்
thank you ஜெயசன் thank you
okay 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 கலை
thank you sir
கலை கங்க்ராச்சுலேஷன்ஸ் கலை நைஸ் பிரசன்டேஷன் we enjoyed the presentation சார் இருக்கங்களா சார் ரஜினி சார் சார் கங்க்ராச்சுலேஷன்
thank you கண்ணா
வாங்க சீக்கிரம் வாங்க யுனிவர்சிட்டி let's meet
yeah, I'm in the university only
சரி சார் ஓகே சார்
கலை வெயிட் பிளெஸிங்ஸ்ல வாங்குறே
ஒண்ணு ஜெல்லற thank you all of you sir we have an indian player hockey player kannan anna with us
Yes.
Karana, Romba, thank you so much.
Kalai, innum andha pera solala.
Sir, sorry, sir.
Kalai, engala ella alavichitta pa, adhu treat vekkalam pa. Kalai.
Vechiralam, sir.
Sir, romba sandosham, sir.
Na kalana kekkalana.
Thank you so much, Manilagi sir, for being with us and for your wonderful words. Very keen on the topic and concluding remarks. Thank you so much. And I also thank everyone, my fellow faculty members, Hockey Fraternity, as well as the scholar, everyone. With
Hockey is in the north. Hockey is in the north. Hockey is in the north.
Shall we wind up? At the same?
இல்ல அவங்க மணிலா சார் செலவு கிவனோ கேக்குறாங்க சார்
ஜி ஷாலி சார் ஷாலி வைண்ட் அப் சார் ஹலோ
அவங்க வைண்ட் அப் பண்ணலாம் சொல்றாங்க ஜி
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. 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 Thank you
போயிட்டாரு நினைக்கிறேன் போயிட்டாரு சார் போயிட்டாரு
யோ கலை பிரசன்டேஷன் சூப்பரா பண்ணு கலை நல்லா வந்துச்சு கலை
थैंक यू ராஜ் थैंक यू so much ராஜ்
சரி சரி டாக்டர் கலை ஐட்ட வாழ்த்துக்கள்
थैंक यू थैंक यू
so much நான் கலை நான் வாழ்த்துக்கள்
ஏய் யார் பேர் வரல
ஏய்
थैंक यू
மாமா கன்கிராட்லேஷன்ஸ் மாமா
so much ராஜ்
थैंक यू
கோதர் थैंक यू so much
thank you so much sir.
சூரத
ஹலோ சார் ரெக்கார்டிங் ஆஃப் பண்ணீங்க சார் டாக்டர் சார்
ஆ எட்டாச்சு